January, and I think a lot of you are already ready with a huge list of books you want to read this year. And what are you reading this month? I have been really excited to make this video since over 15 days because it's my January TBR, which is happening in the mid of the month. But without further ado, we should get started with this video where I'm going to tell you about some amazing books that I plan to read this month. Hi guys, I'm Manpreet and I make book related videos on this channel. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe, turn that bell notification button on so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. I post every odd day and there are surprise videos for you guys every once in a while. So make sure you subscribe, notification should be on, and let's get into this video. I really wanted to do this swish thing. Not good at direction, Manpreet, not good at direction. First three books that I'm going to show you have been sent to me by authors for review, and I'm really excited to read these books and I'm really hopeful that I will love them so that I can really talk about them. Otherwise, I really do not want to talk about the books that I do not like in this year. For example, a lot of you have been asking me to review Turtles All the Way Down, but the thing is I did not like it much, so maybe I will never talk about it much. But book number one is something I'm really loving because it's a poetry collection and it's Glimpse of the Truth by Prasad Agte. Now this is a collection of romantic poetry. Now what I really looked for in a book about, like in a poetry book, was that it should be easy to read, it should be easily comprehensible, because I am not a person who has read a lot of poetry in her life. I have read in school, I have read a couple of poetry books and reviewed them on this channel, but not much, right? So I wanted something easy which would be great for beginners, because I know a lot of my viewers are also beginners in reading. So is this a book which would help you out in that? I think it's a definite yes, although I do not really like the cover. Like, this cover totally does not do justice to what's in the book. But more about this in my review video, so make sure you subscribe so that you can catch the review of this poetry book by an Indian author. Number two book that I'm going to read is Intern Abroad This Summer by Aniket Singh. Now, Aniket Singh is a person who wants to explain to you how it's very easy to get paid foreign internships. And in this book, he has explained how to do it. So it's typically a non-fiction book, which is highly beneficial, especially for the engineering students. Because, oh my god, how awesome it would be. I wish I had like something, a resource like that when I was working. I used to work in ISEC, but I never thought about going on a foreign internship, which I think I should. Right? But this is a book about how you can go there, how you can actually get a foreign internship which is paid. Now, I will read this book and review it on this channel if I really like it. And I'm really excited because, you know, I wanted to read a lot of non-fiction books, and on my blog I talk a lot about engineering, BTech advice and all that stuff, so it will be really helpful to me as well. The next book is again something which is very close to what I did, what I studied. There are a lot of people who are like throwing a lot of hate on me, like she's illiterate or something. By the way, I did my engineering degree at 84%, 83.5 I guess, yes. And I got 5 placement offers from MNC, so I'm not that illiterate, okay? But I am obviously really excited about this book because it's The Big Switch. It's Never Too Late by John Thomas. It's basically about this software engineer who is now working, but he's feeling like, this is not what I was meant to do. I need to change. And it's about his struggle to totally change his entire life, you know, to switch his career and all the problems that he faces, which is something like I think I would be really able to connect to it, because that's what I did. Right after I got out of college, I switched to this life and it was kind of big switch and there were a lot of struggles, so I think I can relate to it. So I am really excited to read this book. Moreover, I'm gonna read it on Kindle because it's available as an ebook, and it's also really good because I need to take my Kindle because I'm going somewhere very soon. Follow my vlogs for that if you want to know where I'm going. So I need my Kindle and need some good books in the Kindle. So I am going to read this book then, and I'm really excited about it. Now the next few books are the ones which I've already read, so I'm gonna try my best to not give you any hints about what I felt about them, because then you will not watch my wrap-ups, okay? So let me get started. Number one book that I plan to read and I have already read is To the Moon by Malini Agarwal. Now this is the blogger behind MissMalini.com. She is a very famous celebrity blogger and she has written this memoir, come self-help book, where she has explained how to run your own business, and she also tells you about her life. A lot of Mumbai talk, which got me really excited. And there was also pain in my heart because of that. But yes, I really like this book, but I'll talk more about it in my review video. Next book is again a memoir. Now guys, if you did not watch my New Year's resolution videos, I'll link it up. You should watch it, because in my New Year resolutions video, I told you that I want to read 51 non-fiction books this year. And yes, I kind of cheat, and I always tell you about it, okay? So, I am kind of cheating a bit, because the memoir are actually, people do not consider them as pure non-fiction, because they think that memoir is something which is close to non-fiction, but it could also be considered fiction. Memoirs are not really non-fiction. I'm still gonna count them as non-fictions and, you know, meet my goal of 51 non-fictions this year. And I already read the second book for that as well, and that is The Perils of Being Moderately Famous by Soha Ali Khan. Like, you should see my Goodreads review to see how much I love this book. It is a very short but a very quick read, and I really loved how Soha Ali Khan narrates, how she talks in the book. And it was an amazing time to read this book. Like, I started reading it at night, in the morning it was finished. So I loved it. But not going to talk about it much, because I'm going to review it very soon. So make sure you catch that review as well. Next two are actually my first two reads of the year, and they were not that great. And that is the Forever series by Novoneel Chakraborthy. Now, first book is Forever is a Lie, which was a total disappointment. Read my Amazon and Goodreads review to see why they were totally disappointment. But I will be reviewing this series as well on my blog and on the channel, because a lot of you requested it. I kind of do not want to, but you requested it, so I will do it. It's about this 18-year-old-ish college student who falls for this guy named Mean Monster, and he's not at all interested in something like love or anything, and that is what the story is about. It's a thriller. Novoneel Chakraborthy is known for writing his thrillers with a little bit of adult content thrown into it. Content, like, I just cannot speak. I feel like this book has jinxed my speech. But yes, if you are like below 18, try not to read these books. But otherwise, I did not feel very much impressed with these books. This one was much better, Forever is a True. But this one, I felt like, let me not talk about it. I will keep it for my review video. Next book is again by the same author, Marry Me Stranger. So we chose this book as our book of the month for our book club read. If you're not a part of that book club, make sure you check the Facebook link down below. You can join the Facebook group, participate in the polls, and then we can have a discussion on the end of the month in a live video. So this is what we chose, Marry Me Stranger, which is a book one in the Stranger series. Now, Stranger series is actually one of the most... Never have two dogs in your house, please. Stranger series is actually one of the most popular and notable works of Novoneel Chakraborthy, and we chose it, so we are gonna read it. Next book is something which you guys wanted me to review very quick, but guys, it's a pretty slow read. It's very nice, but a very slow read. So when I finish it, I will review it, and it's 100 Little Flames by Preety Shenoy. Now, it's about this guy who goes back to his village in Kerala, and you know, the story goes onwards with that. There is a mystery element in this book, there is a nice Kerala vibe, and it's actually pretty good. I will talk more about it in my review video, but yes, I am reading 100 Little Flames, and I know a lot of you will be excited about it, and I'm also really excited to read this. Next two are again non-fictions. One is 3000 Stitches by Sudha Murthy. I told you guys that I really want to read more Sudha Murthy. I haven't read her ever, which is so bad. So this is about these inspirational stories about, you know, different people. That is what I believe. I haven't read much of the, you know, what the book is about. I just needed to read this author. So I picked up whatever book which was releasing. I think this was the latest release. Maybe, maybe not, don't quote me on that, but yes, I bought this recently, so it looks really new, it looks really nice, so I want to read it quick. Another one which I really wanted to read is Girl Boss by Sophia Amaruso. Now, she is the founder of Nasty Girl, and this is like a self-help book which is supposed to inspire women a lot, and that is just the kind of book I needed. So I am really excited to read this book, guys. I waited for the longest time to get a good discount on Amazon for this book. So I really want to read it just this month. There is no if or but, or I'm sorry, in this. I really want to read it this month. And now the last book is actually a reread. So it's City of Bones by Cassandra Clare. If you have been following my channel, you would know that I am not a big fan of the Mortal Instruments series. I have read 4 books in the series, then I was not that impressed. But Emma from Emma Books is doing this year-long readathon for all the Cassandra Clare books which have been published as of now. And I really wanted to, you know, participate in a readathon, and I felt like this is a good way to finish all my Mortal Instruments series, which is kind of not visible today because I'm sitting on a chair and shooting a lot of videos. But yes, I want to finish all the Cassandra Clare books because I already have them on my shelf, and yes, that is why I felt like participating in this readathon. I'm supposed to read this book by 27th of this month. I'll finish it, guys. A big shout out to my dad for helping me with this video because all the books like fell down. So yes, guys, these are all the books that I plan to read in this month in January. Some of them I have already read. Some of them I just need to pick up a pace and, you know, finish all of these books. I'm really excited about my January TBR. Let me know what you plan to read in the next month or in the next few days in the comments down below. Make sure you comment. Do not stop watching this video without commenting, okay? You watched this till now, that means you should comment. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I hope you discovered some new book which might be helpful to you, which might entertain you, or which might interest you. If that happened, do let me know in the comments below, because that is my purpose of making this video and also to keep myself accountable. I'm way too selfish. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. This might be signing off. I'll be back with another video very soon.